trawled in the deep, cold fishing grounds off the coast of Namibia. Horse mackerel, caught and frozen on board ship. Landed, boxed and ready in the port of Walvis Bay. A source of affordable protein for Africa.
We've made a calculation, you know, that we feed about 8 million people daily with Namibian horse mackerel.
Kali Jacobs manages Orongo Fisheries, one of three players in the horse mackerel trade in Walvis Bay.
The fishing industry is currently the third biggest earner of revenue in terms of the gross domestic product of Namibia.
A few decades ago, stocks were so depleted by overfishing that many feared they would never recover. But the industry's been nursed back to health.
The Namibia resource is probably one of the best protected in the world at this point in time. Where you hear that most of the other fisheries are being over-exploited or maybe in trouble, the Namibian resource and management of the resource is doing very well.
Which means that instead of being at sea, trawlers are often in port.
These boats here in Walvis Bay Harbour are tied up because the Hague fishing grounds out there are closed for a month. The fish are spawning, and both government and local fishermen want the stocks to be replenished.
Limiting the fishing season helps preserve stocks, but leads to another problem. For example, with the valuable pilchard industry.
Because the pilchards is seasonal, for instance, this year we start catching closer to by the end of April, and by the end of July we've been finished. So for the rest of the year, we're sitting with this huge infrastructure, capital investments that is unutilized, and therefore we have to do something to get that up and running.
So Peter Greaves' pilchard cannery brings in frozen pilchards with the help of a South African company, Oceana.
They source for us frozen cutlets in the Moroccan market, which we import then from there, and which we're putting through a process then in our cannery, where we can the product and export them again to South Africa.
So Greaf is able to keep his factory open and his workforce employed for more than just a few months a year.
I think our biggest challenge in this country is job creation. With the frozen pilchards that we can here, this process, we employed about 280 people on a 24-hour cycle, 140 people per shift. It's not new employment, it is employers that is currently work for us, but at least they work for longer periods during the year, and thereby they can earn some more money.
Another company, Mirlis, processes, packages and exports deepwater hake. The government requires that fish caught in Namibian waters should be landed and processed in Namibia, adding value to the local economy. So fish destined for Spain is packaged in Walvis Bay.
To create jobs here, it's very, very important for the government, because there's a lot of unemployed young people here in Namibia. So that's why we have to create jobs here.
Mirlis largely employs local high school graduates as a way to target youth unemployment.
Young people only with grade 12, and they're typically here for 3, 4, 5 years and save money, so they can go on further on studying. Sometimes they are 18, 19 years old when they come here, and then they leave 3 or 4 years later and ready for education.
Unemployment estimates vary widely, but most surveys suggest at least one third of Namibians are out of work.
We can also see it when we open the cannery again for the frozen pilchards. They're really in need of work, and they're standing long queues outside of the gates, and That is sad not to employ them all.
The fishing and canning industries can employ some, but only if the fish in Namibia's waters don't become a dwindling resource. Robyn Curnow, CNN, Walvis Bay, Namibia.